Welcome friends, let us continue to study about the engineering graphics on my YouTube channel. Kindly like and share this video and subscribe my YouTube channel. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the engineering curves and particularly about the conics. Definition of the conics according to the eccentricity and application of conics. Conics. The locus or a path of a point moves in a plane such a way that the ratio of its distance from fixed point, which is known as a focus, to a fixed straight line, which is known as a directrix, is always constant. So conics or a conical curve are nothing but a path followed by a point in a such a way that its ratio of its distance from fixed point to fixed straight line is always constant. This is known as a directrix. So fixed straight line is known as a directrix. This is the axis, and the intersection of directrix and axis, let us call it a C. There is a point on a axis, and that is known as a focus or a fixed point. So fixed point is known as a focus or a F. Now let us see, there is a point P located here, and what will be the ratio of point P from the focus in a fixed straight line? So that is the ratio is PF divided by PM. So that is ratio of that point P. So distance of a point from focus, that is PF, divided by distance of that point from directrix, that is M. So that is PM. So the ratio is PF divided by PM. Now let us find out the another point, and that is point is V. Again, the ratio of that V will be equal to VF by VC. And if these two ratios are same, and similarly we can find out number of points in a such a way that value of that ratio is constant. And if when we connect all these points, we are going to get this curve, and this curve is known as a conics or a conical curve. So this curve is known as a conics or a conical curve. And that ratio is known as the eccentricity. It is denoted by the symbol small e. This V, there is a point on a conical curve when it crosses or intersects the axis, that is known as the vertex. So now again let us define the conics on the basis of the ratio or eccentricity. So distance of a point on a curve from the focus divided by distance of that point on a curve from a directrix, and that is known as the eccentricity, that is equals to small e. If there is a P on the curve, the ratio will be equal to PF divided by PM. Similarly, if there is another point on the curve, that is Q, then the ratio or the eccentricity will be equal to QF divided by QN. And similarly, vertex, again vertex is point on the conical curve which intersects with the axis. So that is a V. So V is also point on the curve, and therefore the ratio for the vertex V equal to VF divided by VC. So here we have studied the definition of the conics according to the eccentricity. But we know that the conical curves are not only one. The conical curves are ellipse, parabola and hyperbola. Then for the different curve, that is the ellipse, parabola and hyperbola, the ratio is fixed but it is different. Now let us see what is it. Ellipse is the focus of a point which moves in a plane so that the ratio of its distance from a fixed point and a fixed straight line is always constant and is less than 1. So if that ratio is less than 1, then we are going to get the curve ellipse. So consider this is a directrix, this is x6, this is a focus, this is a curve ellipse. Because it is a conical curve, we know that ratio of that is eccentricity of a point on ellipse will be constant and it will be less than 1. Now let us see, this is a vertex, because vertex is nothing but the intersection of ellipse and axis. This is point P. Ratio in this case is PF divided by PM, and eccentricity is equals to PF divided by PM. In terms of another point Q, the eccentricity is equals to QF divided by QN. In term of vertex, it is VF divided by VC, and it is always less than 1. And that is known as the ellipse. Uses or the application of ellipse. Shape of a manhole in boiler or any other equipments, shape of tank in tanker, flanges of pipe, glands and stuffing boxes, shape used in the bridge and arch, monuments, path of earth around the sun, and shape of trace. So these are the, you can say, application of ellipse. Parabola. For the parabola also, the eccentricity or the ratio is always constant, but here it is equal to 1. So parabola is the locus of a point which moves in a plane so that the ratio of its distance from a fixed point and a fixed straight line is always constant and equal to 1. So let us see, this is a directrix, this is the axis, this is a focus or a fixed point, and this one is the parabola. And this is the vertex, that is the intersection of parabola curve or a conical curve with the axis. This is the point P on parabola. So eccentricity in case of parabola is PF divided by PM. Consider there is another point Q on parabola, that is QF divided by QN, and here that ratio or the eccentricity is equals to 1. And if the eccentricity we calculate in terms of vertex, it will be VF by VC is equals to 1. It means the distance of V from F and distance of V from C is same. Application of parabola. Motor car headlamp reflector, sound reflector and detector, bridge and arches construction, shape of cooling tower, path of a particle thrown at any angle with the earth. You can see here, there are different, you can say, games. Here, you can see here, if anybody throws the ball to the basket, again, this path is parabola. If anybody throws the ball from the boundary to the wicketkeeper, again, that path of that ball is nothing but the parabola. If you can say in any game, if we throw anything, then again it is the path is the parabola. Hyperbola. In the hyperbola also, the eccentricity or the ratio is constant, but here in case of hyperbola, it is greater than 1. So if we recall, for the ellipse, it was less than 1. For the parabola, it was equal to 1, and now for the hyperbola, it is greater than 1. So the hyperbola is the locus of a point which moves in a plane so that the ratio of its distance from a fixed point and a fixed straight line is constant and it is greater than 1. Again, let us see, this is directrix, this is axis, this is focus or a fixed point, capital F. This one is the hyperbola. This is the vertex, that is the intersection of conical curve with the axis, that is vertex V. And consider this is point P on hyperbola. So eccentricity for the hyperbola will be equal to PF divided by PM. So eccentricity is equals to PF divided by PM. If there is another point on the hyperbola, that is Q, then it is a QF divided by QN. And here that ratio is always greater than 1. So for the hyperbola, it is greater than 1. So the application of hyperbola, nature of graph of Boyle's law, shape of overhead water tanks, shape of cooling towers in thermal power plant, monuments or architecture. So these are the applications of hyperbola. Kindly ask your queries in the comment box of the video. Kindly like and share this video and subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.